and world welcome to join us for this edition of AFN English News, and I'm Abdul Ahad Mohammadi. The U.S. commander of NATO troops in Afghanistan has apologized over reports that foreign troops had improperly disposed of copies of the Holy Quran. In a statement, General John Allen ordered a full investigation and said the action was not intentional. When we learned of these actions, we immediately intervened and stopped them, he added. Reports of the alleged Holy Quran burning have led to a large protest outside the U.S. airbase at Bagram. Police say that about 3,000 people were taking part in the demonstration, and some elders have gone into the base to talk to NATO officials. U.S. President Barack Obama has telephoned his Afghan counterpart Hamid Karzai and discussed regional support for Afghan-led reconciliation process in the war-torn country, the White House said. They discussed regional support for Afghan-led reconciliation. The Afghanistan-Pakistan-Iran trilateral meetings last week in Islamabad and other strategic issues of mutual concern, the White House said in a statement. Obama and Karzai agreed on Monday to speak again soon to remain closely aligned as both countries continue their efforts to achieve common goals and work to forge a long-term partnership, the statement added. Afghan government is launching an ambitious plan to spy on its own soldiers, the most serious attempt so far to halt a string of attacks by Afghan troops on their Western comrade in arms, according to Afghan and American military officials. It comes after gunmen in Afghan police uniforms opened fire on NATO troops, killing an Albanian soldier and wounding another, officials said. 11 suspected policemen were arrested. As part of the effort, agents from the National Directorate of Security will be deployed to army units across the country to monitor soldiers at every step from recruitment and training to deployment and home leave, the officials added. Taliban militants have beheaded four men for allegedly spying for the government in southern Helmand province, an official said Tuesday. The bodies of the men were discovered in Washir district late on Sunday, provincial spokesman Dawood Ahmadi said. The Taliban had found satellite phones in the men's possession and thought they were spies, he said, adding that mobile phones do not work in the district and it is normal for people to use satellite phones. The militants, who have in the past used beheading as a punishment on alleged spies, were not immediately available for comment. Rebel-held areas of the central Syrian city of Homs are coming under intense bombardment from the Syrian army. Anti-government activists report that 12 people have been killed so far on Tuesday and 100 injured. Activists have been warning of reinforced government forces around Homs ahead of a ground assault on the city. Thousands have died there in an 11-month uprising against the government. Human rights groups believe more than 7,000 people have been killed since the uprising began. The Syrian government says at least 2,000 members of the security forces have died fighting militants. People in Yemen vote on Tuesday to elect a new president, ending current leader Ali Abdullah Saleh's 33-year rule. Voters are expected to rubber stamp Vice President Abdul Rabu Mansour Hadi, the only candidate in Tuesday's poll. It comes after a year of violent anti-government protests in the Arabian Peninsula's poorest country. Violence continued on Monday, with at least one polling station reportedly attacked in the south. One person is said to have been killed. The election follows a deal brokered by Yemen's Gulf Arab neighbors. Eurozone finance ministers have agreed on a second bailout for Greece after marathon talks in Brussels. Greece is to receive loans worth more than 130 billion euros. In return, Greece will undertake to reduce its debts to 125 0.5% of its GDP by 2020 and accept an enhanced and permanent presence of EU monitors to oversee economic management. Greece needs the funds to avoid bankruptcy on 20th March when maturing loans must be repaid. After five straight years of recession, Greece's debts currently amount to more than 160% of its gross domestic product. Iran has warned it may extend an oil embargo imposed on Britain and France to other European countries and launched a military exercise to strengthen key nuclear sites against airstrikes as a team of UN inspectors arrived in the country. Herman Nakaretz, the leader of the five-member UN team, said he wanted concrete results from the two-day visit, the second within a month. But Ali Akbar Salehi, Iran's foreign minister, told a news agency that the officials would not be inspecting any sites. That's all for now. Thanks for being with us.